There are two major problems with the E-M1 Mark III and E-M1X when powering them through the USB-C port. So the first problem is, if you're outputting video via HDMI and then you plug in the USB-C power delivery, the HDMI will switch off. And the second problem is that if you're doing video recording and you plug in the USB-C for power delivery, then it will interrupt the video recording. So the video recording stops and you have to start the video recording again. So the solution for that is to use the AC5 adapter together with the HLD-9 grip on the E-M1 Mark III and essentially use it to plug it in into this port. And that will overcome both of those problems. So you can have the HDMI out to go to another device for video recording or monitoring. And also if you're doing video recording and you plug in the AC5 adapter into this port on the HLD-9 grip, then it won't interrupt the video recording if video recording has already started. So the HLD-9 grip together with the AC5 solves both of these problems for both the E-M1 Mark III as well as for the E-M1X. Although on the E-M1X, you already have the built-in grip here, so you don't need an external grip for it. Now the problem with this solution is that you need to have access to a power outlet. So the way to overcome that is to use a power bank together with what is called the trigger cable. So a trigger cable essentially lets you connect the USB-C side to a USB power bank that provides power delivery. So the power bank needs to provide enough power for power delivery. So that's 9 volts at 3 amps. And then this side will actually output that 9 volts at 3 amps. So it's important to emphasize that this cable, the trigger cable, is not a normal converter cable. And it's specifically called trigger cable because inside the connector part here, instead of just having connections going through, you actually have a chip which communicates with the power bank and essentially requests 9 volts at 3 amps. So in fact, here you have, I don't know if you can see this here, but it says 9 volts at up to 5 amps. So the power bank will provide 9 volts at 3 amps, and that's enough for running this camera, but this cable supports 9 volts up to 5 amps. So this cable will let you run video with the E-M1 Mark III and the E-M1X by outputting the HDMI. And also you can do video recording without having any interruption to it if you plug this in halfway through video recording. So I'm just going to show it on the E-M1 Mark III, but it's the same for both the E-M1X and the E-M1 Mark III. Okay, so here you can see the video recording is in progress. So I'm going to plug in the USB-C trigger cable into the anchor power bank that provides enough power, which is 9 volts at 3 amps. And this side of the cable, I'm going to plug it into the HLD-9 grip to power it. So as you can see, the battery icon disappeared, which means the camera is being powered via the power bank and the HLD-9 grip. And you can see that video recording continued seamlessly. And I can unplug it and video recording should still continue. And you can see that it went back to using the batteries in the grip. So this solution with the trigger cable solves both the problem of powering the camera through the USB-C port when outputting video via HDMI, as well as if you've started video recording and the battery is running out, you can plug this in without the video recording being interrupted. Now, another advantage of these trigger cables is that you don't actually need to have the AC5 adapter anymore, because what you can do is just have some USB-C adapters which have power delivery with multiple ports, and then you can use the trigger cable to run the batteries. And obviously you can use these type of USB-C adapters for powering other devices or charging batteries and anything else. So it reduces the amount of power supplies that you need to have to charge cameras and batteries, and it just makes it easier to have less equipment. Anyway, let me know if you have any questions about this or if you want me to demonstrate this further.